Hi, Molly Tigger here. It's been a very long time since I've been on, but I have been busy. I've been crafting the last couple months, but in between, not consistently. I have a lot of things going on here at the house, maintenance-wise, and trying to get people to work and get the job done is a whole different story. But anyway, I was making favors for my granddaughter's, she's in first grade, and I came across Scrappy Bookworm's tutorials, and I fell in love with them. So I made the little cauldron baskets, as you can see on the right, and I thought they were so adorable. The trick-or-treat sign and the broom I did with my silhouette, and then the little poison bottle was a stamped image, and I just fussy cut it. And I filled it with some, as you can see, Halloween-type colored grass. I will leave a link down below for the tutorial if anyone is interested. Then on the side, I made a Halloween rosette wreath, and I absolutely loved the way it came out. As a matter of fact, my neighbor wants one, and if I have time, I will try to make her one. The ghosts were, again, from I cut out from my silhouette, and really the other things were just stickers that I used on them. So I absolutely enjoyed making these, and I thank her so much. And I will leave a link below for both videos, so if anyone is interested in making them, you can see how they were done. What took me time was with the cauldron, there was so many little components that I had to put together, so it took me a bit longer. And then because she's in first grade, I didn't want to just leave it with the handle that way. I wanted it to be in a bag, so then I ended up cutting out a topper and stamping her name on that so that you know, it would be easier for the little ones. They don't drop them and lose them. They can just take the little bags home. I'll see if I can get a little closer. I'm standing away. Let's see. But that's it. So I did the toppers, and like I said, and that's the cauldron itself. Really was fun to make. If I only had a few to make, it would have been so simple. But I made about 22 of them, so it was a little more monotonous, you know, like I said, doing the components and cutting out all the pieces. I did use my silhouette to cut out everything other than the handles, because it was just so much easier and faster to do it that way. And I really enjoyed doing the rosette wreath. I really did. The only thing I found a little difficult, and again, that's just me, the bigger one, trying to hold it down to get the hot glue and do the circle. I mean, doing the rosette itself was nothing. That was easy. But trying to hold them down, you know, to glue the circle on to keep it together. So I haven't forgotten about a giveaway. I am still going to do it. Like I said, I am so busy here right now. I watch my grandchildren, as you all know, all year long. And my daughter actually was cleaning out her craft room, and I now have became owner of her heat press with the vinyl. And so I haven't started that. I do want to learn it. I think I will start with things not using the heat press first and then go to the heat press. But for now, I enjoy my paper crafting. And Scrappy Bookworm, I thank you so much for your tutorials. You are so very clear and understandable, and it makes it very easy for me to follow. Thank you, everybody, and have a good day.